Induction heats ferrous metals, metals containing iron, using magnetic fields. This attachment's field bounces back and forth from pole to pole and is strongest in the middle by the size of a golf ball. The closer the load, object being heated, the faster it will heat. It also creates heat by the resistance of current through its load. The better the conductor of electricity, the less amount of heat created through resistance. But don't worry, we don't create enough current in ferrous metals to do damage to electronics outside of the effective field strength. The strongest part of the field is within 2 inches of the attachment. This is a demonstration of the effective range of the magnetic field on the glass blaster. Our first application of the glass blaster is removing bonded autoglass. Since we heat the window from the outside of the vehicle, in most cases we don't need to do any preparation, like removing the interior trim. However, in rare cases, there may be electronic equipment mounted to the glass near the edges of the window. We want to remove this ahead of time. We want to know where the urethane bead is located. One way to do this is by using the L wedge. Laying flat up against the glass on the inside of the car, slide the L wedge until it stops and take a measurement of where the frit ends. The frit is the black masking on the glass that masks the construction underneath. Now, bring the L wedge back to the outside and make a marking on the glass where the urethane bead is located. Do this to all four sides. We now want to start where the urethane bead lies, with an arrow to the center of the glass. Start in a corner and work 6 to 8 inches down each side of the glass. This allows us to get the greatest amount of pressure farther down the window. The most important step we need to do at this point is apply outward pressure. So we're going to push from behind and or out with the L wedge. The initial corner takes the longest, but once the corner is released, the urethane then releases easily. We work this method all the way around the glass. Some windows have a rubber encapsulation which we can't damage if we intend to save the glass. So be careful as you learn the tool, not to push the rubber against the vehicle as heat can distort it. As we slide the L wedge down the glass, be cautious that you don't overheat, as the paint becomes more easily marred. Often, the paint will come off with the urethane bead. Proper installation preparation is required, as industry standard. Before you know it, we've worked all the way around the glass. We got this window out in about 9 minutes. Spray on bed liners can be a bear to remove by conventional methods. With the glass blaster attachment, we can reduce labor time up to 88%. It is easiest if we score the liner before we heat. Place the attachment only on the liner, as the liner protects the attachment from the radiant heat created. Using a metal scraper, follow the area heated. Be careful not to heat the metal scraper within the magnet's effective field. SMC panels can't often be salvaged with knives or wire due to inaccessibility to the angles. Since these panels can be scratched more easily than glass, we want to protect the panel from the attachment with a dry rag. Since finding the urethane bead can often be tricky with SMC panels, we have to bend the panel and want to look for a reflection of light in the bend, which indicates where the urethane bead lies. This SMC panel was removed in 13 minutes. You may have the concentrator attachment as the U-series or the I-series version, both of which do the same job equally. Seized, frozen, rusted, or threadlock compound bonds can often call for other means to nut and or bolt removal. Though a torch can effectively work, it more likely will cause collateral damage. So we're going to use the concentrator attachment to create a flameless and precise heat on the nut or bolt. The fiberglass cloth protects the attachment from heat damage caused by accidental touching. If this is damaged, replace before using again. Place the attachment up to the nut while keeping an air gap between the attachment and the nut. Only a few seconds is needed for most applications. Be aware that overheating the nut by any method can cause a change in the molecular structure of the metal, and the nut should then be discarded. Put a wrench on there and remove the nut. If it is a bolt that is stuck, hold the attachment up to the end of the bolt and heat long enough to allow the heat to flow down the length of the bolt. Now that the bolt has expanded in its housing, the internal bond has broken. However, it is also even more frozen in there. Allow the bolt to cool and zip out. Seam sealer and caulking are difficult and messy to remove with traditional wire wheels. Removal with the concentrator can save time and eliminate the mess. Start at the end of the channel and heat. Once enough heat is applied, scrape up with the L wedge. Keep constant outward pressure on the strip as you heat. You can see that we did not camouflage the spot weld with grind marks. Now we know exactly where to drill to remove this panel. The fast-off pad has a reversible strap for adjustment, and either side can be used for even wear. With body side molding removal, traditional methods leave torn foam and adhesive behind in the metal. Induction heat only heats the sheet metal behind the molding, allowing the adhesive to stay with the cooler part and the sheet metal left clean. Apply heat to the metal at the end of the molding. After a few seconds, apply outward pressure to the molding. Watch the adhesive release from above to determine the speed of movement. Keep the pad in motion so that you don't overheat one spot. As you see, most of the adhesive and all of the foam backing came off with the molding. Traditional rubber wheels and toxic solvents are expensive consumables and labor intensive. The fast-off pad can reduce labor time by up to 90%. Wave the attachment over the edge of the graphic. Direct contact the metal won't damage the attachment in this application, since radiant heat won't be high. Carefully pull back the corner of the graphic and follow the outward pressure to the area the heat is being applied. The adhesive should come off completely with the graphic. A full-size van de-identification can cost you 1 to 2 rubber wheels and a day's worth of labor. The fast-off pad eliminates the rubber wheel and reduces labor by up to 75%. The fast-off pad has many other uses. Use the diagram of the magnetic field's shape to apply to any ideas you may have. Since most applications for sheet metal don't require a high temperature of heat, this pad can usually be held directly to the metal. And just remember, the pad is flexible. The rosebud has a heat shield that protects the attachment from red-hot surfaces. Feel free to hold this attachment directly to metal without damage to the attachment. We can also use the rosebud attachment for releasing metal bond adhesives. Run the attachment along the perimeter of the door to release the adhesive, and then down the center to release it from the intrusion beam. The rosebud attachment has many other uses. Use the diagram of the magnetic field's shape to apply to any ideas you may have. The rosebud is the best attachment for metal fabrication, as you can hold the attachment directly to metal. Here we have the U555 attachment. The regular duty coils that work with the mini-ductor also work with the U555. Heavy duty coils are only for use with the U555 attachment. Seized, frozen, rusted, or thread-like compound bonds can often call for other means to nut and or bolt removal. Though a torch can effectively work, it more likely will cause collateral damage. So we're going to use the U555 attachment to create a flameless and precise heat on the nut. The U555 can heat any size nut or bolt up to 4 inches and sometimes larger. In an effort to maximize the amount of use out of a coil, we want to use a coil that is slightly larger than the nut that we are heating. Not making contact lessens the friction that rubs through the insulation. The insulation is rated for 1200 degrees Fahrenheit. Heating nuts red hot is not needed and not advised for prolonging the life of the coil. If you're working on an inline application where the coil can't slip over the load, split the coils apart and place the load in between them. If this doesn't work for your application, you can also use the flexible bearing buddy coil.